people of Reddit, what lie have you told a kid just to mess with them? I told them I was a robot, and proved it by doing math in my head. They were in second grade, I was in college, and about the hardest problem they could think up was what's 1,000 plus 1,000? The robotics program over at the college is doing some very impressive things, I told them. A family tradition. If you tell a lie, a black dot will appear on your tongue that only adults will see. In a he said she said argument, it's easy to pick the kid that's telling the truth because he's the only one that will open his mouth. In our family, we tell the kids their nose gets hot when they lie, but only a grown-up can feel it. The kid that's not lying is the one yelling for someone to feel their nose, like a charm. My dad used to tell us that if we lay perfectly still in the backyard for long enough, then vultures would circle us and then land to try and eat us. My brother and I would lay silently in the backyard for hours while my dad sat inside watching TV and drinking beer. Well played, Dad. Well played. Reminded me of how my mother tricked me into eating spinach. She told me that it would make me strong enough to lift the house like Papa. So I would eat a whole heap and she'd run with me outside and I'd try and lift the house, scrunching my eyes up from the effort, and she'd go, "It moved. You lifted it a little bit. Go eat some more. Parents are cunning bastards." My friend's dad when he was little. "Hey buddy, have you been pushing your nipples in every night?" "W what? You haven't been pushing them in? Why would I need to? You know how mommy looks different? She has boobs, right?" "Yes. And men don't. Because we push our nipples in at night. But you haven't been." Commence panic that lasts for several months. "Now you tell me." When my daughter, 3 years at the time, was eating a bag of popcorn, she found an unpopped kernel in the bag and asked, "Daddy, is this a seed?" "Me." "Yes, honey. If you go plant it outside, a popcorn tree will grow." "Her." "Yay. I love popcorn." Runs out to plant it in the backyard. Luckily, she watered it for a couple of days and then forgot about it. The funniest one I heard was a father who was asked about coconuts in a store by his son. He said, "Don't go near those, son. Those are bear eggs." That sounds like a good way to find 3 coconuts being incubated in the kid's toy box. I told to my 3-year-old nephew that my sister's name is Potato. It was 10 years ago. He's still calling her that at every family gathering. A girl named Banana hit on me once. It was a weird time. Backstory: she was an international student from China, and she chose an arbitrary American name, which turned out to be Banana, of all the names she could have chosen. GF's nephew lost a tooth. He was telling me about how he was gonna get his big boy teeth soon. I had a rare moment of intelligent thought and said, "Oh wow, wait till you get your big boy hands." This confused him, and so I explained how, just like your teeth, your hands will need to fall off so that you can grow new ones as you get bigger. Now my hands were pretty chapped and red at the time. Midwest winters can suck it. So I told him he needed to make sure he took really good care of his hands when they were growing in, or they would be all red like mine. This poor little bastard is horrified at this point and asked how he would do anything with no hands. I just told him not to worry. Only one hand falls off at a time. He goes off to contemplate his new knowledge. Well, his dad, the grandparents, and the great-grandparents all get an earful of how Gom said his hands were going to fall off. The grands thought it was hilarious. GF thought it was hilarious. His mom and dad, well, not so much. Got custody of my nieces and nephews. 2 boys 3 and 5, 2 girls 6 and 10, and they are a bunch of little badasses. Nothing would faze them. Until one night at dinner, the 5-year-old stopped his throwing a fit to ask why there was a potato on the floor. I just looked at him and told him about the potato fairy. She comes wherever bad kids are and leaves a potato. Slowly over time, the worse the kids is, the bigger the potato gets. Eventually the potato begins to look like the kid, and the kid develops brown rough spots. Soon after that, the potato turns into the kid but is good, while the kid is now stuck as a potato. He was legitimately scared, and a couple days later when the eyes sprouted, he flipped out. Best use of a potato yet for me. I told my brother that I could turn him invisible. Me and my mum had a lot of fun with this. He truly believed this until he was at least 7. How did you get all those tattoos? I ate a lot of crayons when I was a kid. I ate a red crayon once. Someday you're gonna have a big red tattoo. And that's how little Timmy got wax poisoning. My dad used to mess with me and my siblings all the time. Black-eyed peas are actually spider eyes. If you eat your crust, you will learn how to whistle. I thought he was magic when he made the lights change. He would ask one of us to stand up and show him how tall we were getting. Then would ask us to go fetch something for him. I can't wait to produce little clone workers of my own. When I was in 9th grade, I told a 7th grade girl that whenever a guy has his hand in his pockets, he's masturbating. She ran around the mall pointing people out to me and couldn't believe she had never noticed it before. This thread is supposed to be for lies. I told a kid that a car was essentially four unicycles lashed together, and there were really small people pedaling at super high speed. This is a great way to accidentally crush a kid when it looks for said small people. I told my 9-year-old brother who hates onions that in order to turn 10 he must consume an entire onion as if it were an apple. He did not believe me until the entire family got involved. My father even told him that he didn't get to turn 10 for several years because he had such a hard time eating the onion. Poor kid. Back when pound puppies were the thing, my 4-year-old wanted one badly. He got one for Easter, and I told him he was going to have to make sure he took good care of his new puppy. After he went to bed that night, with his new puppy, I came across some small brown pom-poms from a past project. On a whim, I decided to put a few under his puppy. The next morning, my son came into the living room and asked for some paper towel, so he could clean up the puppy poo. He's 31 now, and we still laugh about it. How adorable. I wish that dogs pooped out pom-poms. It would make cleaning up after them much more pleasant. I'm an amputee and there was that little girl with her mom, and she asked her mom why I was like that. So I told her that's because I didn't eat my vegetables. I have a friend who's about a foot taller than me. We were visiting a family with kids who didn't want to eat their vegetables. I explained that the reason my friend was so much taller than me was because he ate his vegetables growing up, but I didn't. So one nice fall day we were over visiting my sister-in-law and my nephew, who was probably 6 or 7 years old at the time, asked me if I knew who Squanto was. I replied in the affirmative and he asked me to tell him everything I knew about Squanto. So I explained how Squanto invented basketball, how he walked around buck naked all the time and about his terrible and frequent flatulence that the settlers put up with because Squanto was the only guy in America who knew where Chicago was and he promised to drive everyone there in his bus. Right after the first Thanksgiving, which of course was a party thrown to thank good old Squanto for all of his naked farty basketball related help. Turns out the kid was supposed to have been reading some worksheets and completing an assignment about Squanto and decided to not do that and just ask me instead. I got a good talking to a few days later about what I am and I'm not allowed to tell the kids. I am so glad I read this far down. I don't even care if it's true. My dad was the best at this, and I am apparently insanely gullible, so it always worked. So it's the late 80s, early 90s. I'm roughly 10. I go on a Walmart run with my dad in a rental car because our car was in the shop. We park the car, and he says, "Hey, check this out," and says, "Open trunk to the car." The trunk magically pops open. He shuts it, does it again, open trunk, and the trunk pops open. I am amazed. He says, "Yeah, this is how these newer cars work. You can tell it what to do and it will listen," and urges me to try it. So I proceed to walk through the parking lot saying "open trunk" to every single car. None of the trunks open, and he told me it was because those cars didn't recognize me, and I was sad. Little did I know, he has one of those fancy car remotes fobs that open the trunk, unlock the doors, etc. in his pocket. I can't decide if he's a genius or if I'm a complete idiot. In my high school, seniors used to tell the 7th graders that there was a 4th floor pool. Our school only has 3 floors. Some of the teachers got into it too. There was a door on the 3rd floor that said senior pool only, and somebody would occasionally get their feet wet and walk through the hallway leading to the door. Too many fell for that one. Told my niece and nephew that I had a glass eye. My eyes are fine, but I would cross my eyes and look around erratically. I kept this up for about 2 years. They would tell me how real it looked. I said it better it was expensive. When they got up the courage to ask me to take it out, I would say that I had just removed it to wash it a few days ago and it hurts to put in and out. They were always staring at my eyes, watching me but trying not to get caught. Kept them on their toes anyway. Being an uncle is lots of fun. My uncle would tell us that, but then he'd actually take out his fake eye and let us touch it. Then he'd douse it with beer and put it back in. Good times. Are you Tom Cruise? Makes direct eye contact and without missing a beat. Yep. Continues walking opposite direction. I have no idea how the kid knew who Tom Cruise was or if he did at all. I share no similar features, but I like to think that will be his favorite memory years from now. I told my much younger cousins that when I was young, everyone had postal squirrels. We let them out every morning and they'd return with our mail. My bewildered uncle called the next day, saying, "What did you tell my daughters? They won't shut up about squirrel mail." I told my niece that every bobby pin has a different name. Carlos Pin, John Pin, Jose Pin, Alejandro Pin, you get the point. Why are the names all Mexican? I convinced my son that he had a tail. When he was learning body parts, I just added one. "Where is your head?" He would point to his head. "Where are your feet?" He would point to his feet. "Where is your tail?" He would point to this little spot above his butt. He is 4 now and I still ask him about his tail sometimes. He said that it fell off, but he will still tell me where it used to be. And I thought you were going the completely other direction with the tail. My uncle used to tell my cousin and I that the hazard button in the car was the turbo button. Whenever we tried to press it, he would just accelerate when we did. For the longest time, we thought every car, even minivans, had turbos in them. My stepdad told me it blew the car up. I wondered why on earth anyone would need a button like that. I told the kid I babysit that I never poop. He's almost 5 and still believes me. I was asked earlier today, "If you don't poop, why do you have a big butt?" I would have replied, "For storage." I have 3 cats and this 6-year-old was at my house. He wanted to see one of the cats that was hiding under my bed. I grabbed the cat by the scruff of the neck and explained what I was doing. The kid asked me, "Why do cats have a scruff of the neck?" I explained to him that when a cat gets cold, the scruff of the neck swells up and expands over the cat's head like a hood to keep the cat warm. He very excitedly went to explain this to his mom, who did not think it was so funny and gave me a very scornful look. Girl walked into the bank today and noticed cash. The bank's beat a fish in his bowl. She was disappointed that he was just kinda sitting there. So I told her if she yells, "Gullible," he will do a flip. And so she proceeded to yell at the fish bowl, "Gullible, gullible," for about a solid 30 seconds. I feel bad, but at the same time, that really made my day. I have no shame laughing at a person that falls so hard for something so obvious. I had a friend whose elder brother taught her all the wrong names for colors before she attended kindergarten. That must have been fun. My so and I have half jokingly considered doing the same thing to our kids. Balancing psychological damage and hilarious fun is hard. When we get a dog, we will definitely name it Cat though. I told a kid that the human body only has so many words until it runs out and then you die. That's why old people slur their words more, because they are running out. It's a lot of words, millions, but don't waste them when you're a child. They didn't talk for the rest of the day. I told a kid who was misbehaving in a fast food place that if he didn't stop, his parents would leave him there and he'd have to work there forever like an Oompa Loompa. The sad part is that you might not be wrong. When he was 6, I told my freckled, ginger-haired son that he was half black, and then a few years later I told him we were half Jewish. I think he has caught on now, but for a while he was half black, half Latino, a quarter Asian, half Jewish, used to be Catholic, raised Buddhist, descendants from Vikings, and on and on. Actually, anytime we came across anyone who looked or seemed different, I told him he was just like them. It built a lot of bonding and empathy over time with others. I work at a water park during the summers as a lifeguard. I was working at the top of one of the steep speed slides, and naturally every young kid that can go down will ask if anyone has died. When it is especially dead there, I will look them dead in the eyes and say, "Not today." But a couple weeks ago we had a little boy girl just your size that slid off and continued into the woods behind the slide and hadn't been seen since. They freaked a bit and didn't go down. I would have just left it at not today and then continued to stare them down. I routinely tell this to children when they ask why the sky is blue. The sky is blue because we live inside the eye of a blue-eyed giant named Macumba. This thread is supposed to be for lies only. When my wife and I first started dating, my stepdaughters were little, and for some reason, they learned that they couldn't figure out for themselves what the meal was going to be. There were times I'd be starting a pot of water, have spaghetti noodles, sauce, and cheese sitting on the counter, and they'd walk in, look at it, and then ask what's for dinner. This happened often enough, and was followed by, "But I don't like that," often enough that I got sick of it, and one day told the 3-year-old that the pot of soup I had going was actually kittens. SHHHH. Listen, you can hear them mewing, if you're quiet, as the pot is bubbling away. It got to be a thing, and 13 years later, they are still asking what I'm making, and I'm still telling them it's kittens. Silly stepdad, everybody knows kittens should be sautéed, not boiled. Once a kid who I was babysitting was scared of monsters, so I said that there was a monster repelling app on my phone. I said that it made a high-pitched sound that people couldn't hear, but the monsters were afraid of it. So I pretended to open the app and turn the volume up on my phone and set it down on his dresser. He went right to sleep. Now obviously this wasn't to mess with him, but he apparently asked his parents if they could get the app, and I wasn't hired again. Really? That's clever. Why wouldn't they hire you back? I'm a white guy and I served in the Peace Corps in Africa. I was the only white person that a lot of the people in the village had ever seen. I used to tell kids that my poop was white. It made sense to them. My dogs get a raw femur bone to chew on every morning. They tend to be strewn around the living room if I haven't yet cleaned up for the day. One day we had friends visiting, and they came inside the house. We were talking about trespasses or something similar and I motion over to the pile of bones and tell them, "See that? That's what happened to the last person who tried to sneak around." The two young kids, about 6 and 8, got real wide-eyed and were perfect angels the rest of the visit. Whenever a kid is messing around with the conveyor belt at my register, I'll turn it off and pretend he broke it. Sometimes he'll freak out and think he has to pay to have it fixed and it's glorious. Sometimes the parent will think the kid broke it and they freak out and I realize some parents are stupid. That's evil, but funny. My dad would mess with us as kids all the time. A few gems. The Pillsbury Doughboy is real, his name is Poppy. My dad would tie a fishing line to a toy version, then go outside and dangle it by the window where we could see. He claimed Poppy would visit him at the office, and when he gets up to get coffee, Poppy would put little dough balls on his desk as revenge. He told us that tree monkeys lived at night in our backyard. The random waterfalls through rock formations beside a highway were the plumbing for Native Americans living in the caves. He single-handedly fought a million-man Chinese army in the Great Battle of San Francisco. Before color TV, the whole world was in black and white. R explained like in Calvin welcomes you. I'm not entirely sure if this counts, but back when I was 14, I told one of my classmates, who was of a similar age, that airplanes in flight looked small because of the air pressure they experienced. The whole thing started when we were sitting on the top row of the gym's bleachers. We were only about 8 or 9 feet up, but the height was still apparently impressive enough to prompt my companion, whose name was Nick, to consider a career in extreme sports. "Hey, do you think I could jump down from here?" he asked. I turned to him with a look of shock and alarm on my face. "From up here? No way. That's, like, half a mile down." What? He glanced over the edge again. "No, it isn't. No, really, it is," I insisted. "I know it looks close, but that's only because we're inside. There's no air pressure." Nick gave me a quizzical look. "Air pressure? What do you mean?" "Well," I began, "when you're outside, there's air everywhere, right? All of that air presses against things, making them look small. Have you ever looked up at an airplane and thought that it looked really tiny?" Oh, yeah, Nick said, a flicker of understanding crossing his face. "That's because there's a lot of air pressure up there. Most of those planes are only about 50 feet in the air, which is why it's illegal to throw rocks at them. You might hit one and cause a wreck." My companion nodded enthusiastically. Yeah, I heard about that happening. "Anyway," I said, "since we're inside, There's nowhere pressure. Since there's nowhere pressure, everything looks like it's a lot closer, because it's not getting shrunk down. If you jumped off the bleachers, you'd probably die. Nick didn't say anything else, but he slowly scooted away from the edge. TLDR. Profound pressure panic spear. Your school was terrible. When I was my family went to Switzerland, I have two sisters. My older sister and I convinced my twin sister that the Swiss Alps weren't real, but just a giant curtain in the distance like in a movie set. We made fun of her for believing the mountains were real until she was vehemently denying that she ever believed for one second that they were real. Then we told her they were real. I remember this one time when I was my family. Had some alone time and of course I was interrupted. And long story short, that's how I found out incest was illegal when I was 14. I told my kids that Santa only comes to good kids' houses. My oldest, who was 8 at the time, said that Santa didn't come to her best friend's house because she was Muslim. I said yeah, that's just what her parents tell her because she can't handle being told she's bad every year. When I was 10 I had a Muslim friend over around Christmas time and my mom mentioned something about Santa Claus. My friend asked her why Santa never came to his house. She told him that Santa doesn't love Muslims and that he should consider converting to Catholicism if he wanted presents. She said this while his mom was over having coffee with her. Him and his mom never came over again. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.